Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Good morning. Today we celebrate Sunday in the octave of Corpus Christi. So let us begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the second form of the Confiteor found on page 66. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, and what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say one Our Father and one Hail Mary. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, you nourished your people with food of angels and furnished them bread from heaven, ready to hand, untoiled for, endowed with all delights and conforming to every taste.
Substance of yours, your sweetness toward your children, and serve the desire of him who received it, was blended to whatever flavor each one wished.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in this wondrous sacrament, you left as a memorial of the passion and death of your Son, Jesus. May we, who so reverence his body and blood, receive within ourselves the effects of his redemption. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated for our first reading. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction, and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger, and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert, with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock, and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." This is the word of the Lord. Our response is, "Praise the Lord, Jerusalem." Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat he fills you. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Alleluia. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. This is the word of the Lord. The Corpus Christi sequence. Laud, O Zion, your salvation. Laud with hymns of exultation, Christ your King and Shepherd true. Bring him all the praise you know. He is more than you bestow. Never can you reach his due. Special theme for glad thanksgiving is the quickening and the living bread today before you set. From his hands of old partaken, as we know, by faith unshaken, where the 12 at supper met. Full and clear, ring out your chanting. Joy nor sweetest grace be wanting. From your heart let praises burst. For today the feast is holden, when the institution olden of that supper was rehearsed. Hear the new law's new oblation, by the new king's revelation, ends the form of ancient rite. Now the new, the old effaces. Truth away the shadow chases. Light dispels the gloom of night. What he did at supper seated, Christ ordained to be repeated, his memorial ne'er to cease. And his rule for guidance taking, bread and wine we hallow, making thus our sacrifice of peace. This the truth each Christian learns. Bread into his flesh he turns, to his precious blood the wine. Sight has failed, nor thought conceives, but a dauntless faith believes, resting on a power divine. Here beneath these signs are hidden, priceless things to sense forbidden. Signs, not things, are all we see. blood is poured, and flesh is broken. Yet in either wondrous token, Christ entire we know to be. Whoso of this food partakes, does not rend the Lord nor breaks, Christ is whole to all that taste. Thousands are as one receivers. One, as thousands of believers, eats of him who cannot waste. Bad and good the feast are sharing, of what divers dooms preparing, endless death or endless life. Life to these, to those, damnation. See how like participation is with unlike issues rife. When the sacrament is broken, doubt not, but believe, 'tis spoken that each severed outward token doth the very whole contain. Naught the precious gift divides, breaking, but the sign betides, Jesus still the same abides, still unbroken does remain. Lo, the angel's food is given to the pilgrim who has striven. See the children's bread from heaven, which on dogs cannot be spent. Truth, the ancient types fulfilling, Isaac bound, a victim willing, Paschal lamb its lifeblood spilling, manna to the fathers sent. Very bread, good shepherd, tend us. Jesu, of your love befriend us. You refresh us, you defend us. Your eternal goodness send us in the land of life to see. You who all things can and know, who on earth such food bestow, grant us with your saints, though lowest, where the heavenly feast you show, fellow heirs and guests to be. Amen. Alleluia.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever.
This is the gospel of the Lord.
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. So it's taken from today's gospel according to St. John, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, our Corpus Christi sequence that we heard today was written about 1,000 years ago by the angelic doctor, St. Thomas Aquinas, and it contains in it the entire theology that we have of the Eucharist, the body and blood of Christ. And there's a couple things in there that really are striking. One is that no matter how big or how small a morsel, whether it be under one or both species, the bread, body only, the blood only, or both, we receive totally, fully, and completely all of Christ within us. And what happens, though, when we receive Christ within us? Well, he purifies us. But what happens when we purify something? We take out all of the impurities. They are removed. They are cleansed. Just like with gold being purified and with fire, when we purify our gardens or even a forest, it's nature does that itself. And we're seeing that in Canada with the wildfires today. All the old growth that wasn't cleared out is being burned away so that new growth can come forward. And that's what Christ does with us. He takes out all that old gunk that was leftovers from sin. Even when we're forgiven of our sins, there's that little leftovers that are in there that need to be flushed out and purified. And he does that. That's why it's so important to receive the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ as often as possible. Because he helps cleanse us. But also he becomes a part of us and transforms us to becoming more like him. And we become a part of him as well. How beautiful is that, that he gave us that sacrament, that miracle, that we continue to receive today and every day. So as we remember on this beautiful Sunday, within the octave celebration of Corpus Christi, that beautiful 8-day celebration, perhaps we can reflect on those ways that Christ can help us purify our own selves so that we can help purify the world by bringing him into the world as he comes into us. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. With confidence in the love of our Heavenly Father, we bring our prayers to him this day. And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, the body of Christ, that she may continue to grow in holiness and devotion to the Eucharistic sacrifice which gives life to the world, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. for all world leaders, that the sacrificial love of Christ may inspire them to protect the dignity and sanctity of all human life, we pray to the Lord. For an increase in vocations to the priesthood and diaconate in our holy Polish National Catholic Church, we pray to the Lord. For all the sick and their caregivers, especially those on our parish prayer list, that they may find strength and endurance in the love of Christ, we pray to the Lord. For our own special needs and intentions, we hold deep in the silence of our hearts. And for whom this Mass is being offered, which is for the intention of Holy Trinity Parish, we pray to the Lord. For all the faithful departed and those who will die today, that they may enjoy eternal rest in God's heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Loving Father, hear our prayers, both spoken and unspoken, and grant what we truly need. May we grow in deep appreciation of the Eucharist and be more open to sharing the presence of Christ with one another. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, to give us what bread to offer, which earth is given, and human hands have made, may it become for us the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. Water, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless this sacrifice to be prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the passion, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they whose memory we honor on earth intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Gracious Father, grant your church unity in Christ and peace with you. May we who present these gifts to you live according to the spirit of the gospel and come to know eternal life. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. At the Last Supper, as he sat at table with his apostles, he offered himself to you as the spotless Lamb, the acceptable gift that gives you perfect praise. Christ has given us this memorial of his passion, to bring us his saving power until the end of time. When we receive the bread of heaven, We are nourished and strengthened by our Lord to live in holiness and righteousness. We come then to your table to be fed this wonderful sacrament and grow into the likeness of the risen Christ. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints in the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass continues with Eucharistic Prayer 4, which is found on page 88. Blessed are you, Lord of all majesty and King of eternal glory, through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. In him your word was made flesh. In him the fullness of your grace was revealed in splendor. In all things he fulfilled your will and glorified your name. He proclaimed your kingdom to us. He broke the power of darkness over us. He took our guilt upon himself. He reconciled us to you and unlock the new paradise for us. As the way, the truth, and the life, he has revealed your love to us. He humbled himself and became obedient, even to death on a cross, and by rising restored our life. On the night in which he was betrayed, to undergo that suffering which he himself had chosen, he took bread into his hands, and lifting his eyes to you, his heavenly Father, he gave thanks. He blessed the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which is given for you." When supper had ended, he took the cup and gave thanks to you. He blessed it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." Together, your death, Lord Jesus, we proclaim, your resurrection we celebrate, your return in glory we await. Therefore, Father, we remember his saving passion, his glorious resurrection, and his exaltation at your right hand. We await his coming in the fullness of majesty. We here set forth this sign of our faith in him who offered you the perfect sacrifice and gained for us eternal salvation. Send your Holy Spirit, the giver of life and holiness, upon us and upon these gifts, the bread and wine of eternal life. Together, Holy Spirit, come to us. Fill us with your gift of grace. Take these gifts from our hands, Lord God, as an acceptable sacrifice, through which we offer ourselves to you. So that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be a sharing in the body and blood of your Son. May all who receive from your heavenly altar always remain united with you. Together with all your saints and chosen ones, with the blessed and glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of our Lord, with the prophets and apostles, with your martyrs and confessors, and with all who stand about your throne in praise and prayer. Bless your church throughout the world. Grant it unity and peace. Renew the earth according to your promise. Remember all peoples and grant that all nations may give you thanks, worshiping and praising your holy name. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
On page 95, let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Of blessing which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Because there is one bread, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one bread.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also
let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Let's say together the First Communion prayer found on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ,
Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you.
I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life.
Behold, this is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord.
The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ.
body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The 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 body of Christ. The body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. Body and blood of Christ. The body and blood of Christ.
Testify. Now I hang back in the shadows. I wanna come close. I wanna know. She sees me shivering here. She smiles and with a nod. I walk through the mud and straw to the newborn Son of God.
This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever.
Let us pray. Almighty God, may the sacrament of the altar, the pledge of your love for us, move us to long for eternal happiness. We ask this through our Lord, Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you so much for joining us for our Holy Mass today. Masses this week will be Tuesday through Friday because of the Solemnity of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, so we will not be celebrating Mass tomorrow, but Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, as well as the weekend. So we pray that you have a wonderful day. Stay safe. Take care of yourselves. Take care of each other. Remain in the state of grace. Fight evil wherever you find it, and spread joy wherever you go.